Well, first of all, I appreciate you acknowledging that I called it last week.
Because
I said
Monday it was going to happen.
I said last Monday. I ain't hear no other show on ESPN acknowledging that. It just amazes me. But if I was wrong, I'd have heard from everybody. But that's neither here nor there. Here's the reality. Jay Gruden should have been gone. This is too little, too late on the part of Daniel Snyder. Jay Gruden's record as a head coach is 35, 41, 49, and 1. That's 14 games under 500. He has not been impressive, and more importantly than that, again, I don't know the man personally. I'm only echoing the sentiments that have been said about him, which is that they questioned his work ethic. They said that he hid behind Sean McVay. Daniel Snyder, Max Kellerman is ultimately the individual that takes the greatest hit because you had a guy in Sean McVay who was there as your offensive coordinator before he got the Rams job. You had a Kyle Shanahan who was once in your organization. You let him go. So you have individuals that are considered that are highly respected and held in high esteem in the National Football League that are head coaches for other franchises that worked under Jay Gruden. And Daniel Snyder let them walk out the door in favor of keeping Jay Gruden, whose work ethic he questioned. There were questions about his relationship with executive Bruce Allen, although they both denied that there was any friction coming into this season. In the end, here's the reality, and this is the harsh reality. The only reason why Jay Gruden got the head coaching job to begin with, and the only reason why he lasted this long, according to people that I speak to in the National Football League, is because of his last name. John Gruden wasn't with the Oakland Raiders. He was in the Monday night booth telling everybody at the time he didn't want to be a head coach anymore. So they thought that they'd get, just a reincarnation per se, same last name, pedigree, et cetera, et cetera. It did not work out that way. Some people ain't meant to be a head coach. Some people are destined to be coordinators. And Jay Gruden's record as head coach of the Washington Redskins proved just that.
The issue with Washington is the owner, Dan Snyder. And you know what I love about this? Like with Jim Dolan with the Knicks. You keep hiring, firing people, whatever you want to do. The futility on the field is what it is since you bought the team. The more you get rid of guys and bring new guys in, the more we see there's one constant. His record of failure, Dan Snyder, is there for everyone to see. He's the worst owner in the NFL and one of the worst in sports. And by the way, he's almost dangerous because he really is a football fan. Like, he really does love the team, right? But because he doesn't know much compared to actual football people, if he gets attached to a guy, to an idea, he's going to overrule his football people. And that's been reported several times. Stephen A., so a fish rots from the head down. And was Jay Gruden a good coach? Obviously not. If you listen to people like DeSean Jackson, Stephen A., when DeSean Jackson left Philly, he was upset about it. But did you hear him saying things like they don't want to win in Philadelphia and all that kind of stuff? No. That locker room was no good. When he left Washington, and it wasn't even like he said it with malice. It was just like, bro, you walk in there and it's just, they don't think they're going to win. That was the team under Jay Gruden. So, yes, you have to get rid of him. But my point is you can get rid of Jay Gruden, get another guy, whatever. The problem starts at the very top, Dan Snyder. So as a Giants fan, I'm glad he owns the team. I want him to own that team forever. And by the way, that's with sensitivity to the idea that I don't mention their name. I call them the franchise from Washington because I find it highly offensive, that name. And, of course, he defends it and arrogantly doubles down and we're never going to change the name and all this kind of stuff. He's bad on a lot of fronts, the football product being the primary one.
Well, the bottom line is this. They've only won two playoff games since 1992. Since 1992, this franchise, they won a Super Bowl in 1991. They won a playoff game that next year and lost in the divisional playoff round in 1992. Since 1992, spanning nearly 30 years, the Washington Redskins have two playoff games on its resume and only one playoff victory they had a playoff victory in 2005. That was their last playoff victory. They have not won a playoff game since 2005.
We're not talking about Super Bowls here.
They haven't won a playoff game. They haven't won a playoff game. And they've only been at the playoffs three times in the last 14
years. The last in the playoffs, 2015. Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.